Hello. What is the time? It's like 5 to 4 in the morning. It's Friday night. Nights until Saturday. And I'm going to paint these roses that I picked today. I'm going to paint a kind of an impressionist painting. See if I can finish it in like 4 or 5 hours. So it'll probably be finished at 9 o'clock in the morning. That's how I live. So I work a lot of, usually work at night. But I can't really make these. I have to do it now because they die very fast or change very fast. So I just have to get it done now. Anyway, I'm going to paint them on this canvas. I hope I can. Usually I work more detailed, so just see what happens. Maybe for a while I decide to take a photograph of it and just keep on painting, but I will actually see what happens. So, yeah, this is my studio. It's quite nice. Made in a classical way. Classical. Yeah. So, nice of you to like my videos, that you learn something from them. Kind of makes it worth it. And I do add people on Facebook, but I like people to send me a personal message and tell me who they are and stuff like that, because I had so many strange people as friends. I kind of don't really add much anymore. So, okay. Thank you. Bye-bye. Yeah. So here we go. What I usually do is that I start up with some points of light. Now you see, it depends how much I want to. Oh, there's one flower there, and I have to count like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe 6, approximately. And that's basically how I do it. I don't have a recipe. I just start somewhere, and then I let my intuition take over. Just points. And I try to judge how the distance between the different objects. I'm gonna have to do like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So maybe 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6.5, basically. I've seen there's a lot of figurative artists who's using projectors, and I find a challenge to get things right to be the most gratifying thing, to challenge myself. I love science, but I'm not a scientist, so I mean, this is the closest I can get to being a scientist. And for me, it's the harder something is, the more fascinating it becomes, in a way. That's why I usually work on huge canvases. Maybe feels like it's a bigger challenge. Maybe I'm lying to myself, because I have also made some small paintings, and it's with figure paintings, and it's quite hard. So maybe I'm not right there. You see, if you take a look at Jan Vermeer, His paintings are his beautiful artwork. He really shows that picture don't have to be big to be good. Big is not necessarily better. You'll see here how I kind of just start with the points and try to, because I'm adjusting this through the whole process. This one's going to be a little bit bigger, I guess, and this one too. If I don't do any really big mistakes, it's gonna wind up to be quite good, I guess. It's like there, so not here, almost here. Like this, yes. I have a group on Facebook. So if anybody have any questions, you could just ask me there, if they add themselves to the group, yeah. Or on YouTube. So I don't always see the things people post on YouTube, but I'm trying the best that I can. Now, here. I'm starting quite fluidly now, because I know I'm not gonna paint on this many times. So is that right? Maybe it's a little bit there. Comes in here. Here. This thing is like a drop. It's beautiful. I took some pictures of a girl that I'm painting with this, holding it, and it became very nice, colors, and you know, the highlights and the glass and stuff like that. It's the kind of thing that makes it interesting. I guess something like this, maybe. Like this. I love how that I can see the end of the roses in the water. It's so beautiful. Anyway, I'm gonna stop babbling and get on with it, and I'm gonna play you. Vertical, a concert by U2. I love U2. It's and they are using their music to do charitable work and promote human rights and stuff like that. And it's a lot of pathos, quite pretentious too, but it's beautiful music, and I like the mood, pathos, whatever. It's hard to talk and paint at the same time, because it's two different brain parts of the brain. So I'm using when I'm painting and talking, so I guess they are colliding right now. Probably like talking and having sex at the same time. It's not a good thing. That's smart. Talking and dancing. Talking and fighting. I don't know. So, well, anyway, now you basically see how I start, so maybe you get something out of it. What I do now is that I start to use the background to get kind of the stilk, stilk in Norwegian, the leaves, and yeah, to just get it out like this. What else here? Okay, anyway, the point is I use the lights behind to kind of drag, make the shapes, and then I fill it in when I'm painting. Yeah, that's what I do. Okay, hope it's helpful. Yeah.
Oh, Thank you. These city walls, these city walls. from my father, Bob. And he thought he was Italian. All he listened to was the opera. And his son grew up and wanted to live the opera. You think you've got the stuff? You're telling me and anyone you're hard enough. Don't have to put up a fight. You don't have to always be right. Let me take some of the punches that you tonight. Oh, dedicate this next song to those who lost their lives in London last week. And you are maimed and injured today. We would like to turn our song into a prayer. The prayer is that we don't become a monster in order to defeat a monster. That's our prayer tonight.
believe everyone has the right to life, liberty, and security of person. 4. No one shall be held in slavery or servitude. Slavery and the slave trade shall be prohibited in all their forms. 5. No one shall be subjected to torture or to cruel, inhuman or degrading treatment or punishment. 6. Everyone has the right to recognition everywhere as a person before the law.
Species. Thank you. beautiful Milano ice cream strings. Thank you. Two great, great, great nights. Thank you so much. We will never, ever forget. Extraordinary thing happened a few nights ago in Albany, where I've never felt so crap, never felt so just really fucked up, really. I never felt so bad. And those crowd of people really carried me, and the band also was a really, really special moment for me. And my voice is back now. And this is this song's about letting go of somebody you don't want to let go of. Could be a lover, could be father, could be a child, could be a friend. This is Kite. Taste the salt of the sea. There's a kite blowing out of control on the breeze. I wonder what's gonna happen to you. You wonder what has happened to me.
Thank you. In New York somewhere.
hundreds. You can't walk around the block without a change of clothing. Hot is a hair dryer in your face. Hot is a handbag and a can of mace. New York, it's a sky place. New York, New York. In New York, you can forget. Forget how to sit still. Tell yourself you will stay in, but it's down to Alphaville. Italians, Jews and Hispanics, religious nuts, political fanatics, and skew. And happily not like me and you, that's where I lost you. Who you are, who you are, who you are, who you are. That's where I lost you.
Oh, I'm gonna go.
We started out, we were, I guess, 15, 16, Larry was 14, still is. The Ramones were the band, and without the Ramones, it's hard to imagine that we would have felt like we felt about, you know, joining the band and all. So this is a song that Joey Ramone loved. They played it to him while he was lying in his hospital bed a couple of months back. It was the last song that Joey Ramone heard in his life here. And that's an amazing thing for somebody who grew up as a fan of Joey Ramone, I can tell you. Anyway, Joey turned this song about a hangover into a gospel song, I think. Because that's the way I always hear it now. Joey Ramone's ears.
In a little while, surely you'll be mine. In a little while, I'll be there. This hurt will hurt no more. I'll be home.
This is a family business. I'd like to introduce you to the scientist in the family. A man who takes sexual pleasure in the collection of data. Wearing the number 7 shirt this evening, even his mother calls him The Edge. On security, the bodyguard of the man, the man who gave us our first job and keeps us in our first job. On the drums, Larry Mullen Jr. Come on down. The jazz man, the musical conscience of the family, a man whose instrument holds mysterious powers over women folk, the poshest member of U2, Adam Clayton, yeah. That's my job. We need to be blind at the same time. Know what I'm saying? green light, 7-Eleven. You stop in for a pack of cigarettes. You don't smoke, don't even want to. Hey now, so you check your change. Dressed up like a car crash. The wheels are turning, but you're upside down. You say when it hits you, you don't mind. Because when it hurts you, you feel alive. Oh no, is that what it is? Red light, gray morning. You stumble out of a hole in the ground. A vampire or a victim. It depends on who's around. Used to stand to watch the adverts. You could have seen to the talk show host. And if you look, you look through me. And if you talk, do that to me. And when I touch you, you don't feel.
Thank you.
Yeah.
chewy. I'm supposed to use, what did I say, 3 hours? I started 4 o'clock in the morning, now it's 12:30 in the daytime, so I used actually 8.5 hours. Going all the way. All the way. And my back is killing me and my head is just overwhelmed. But I think it became quite nice actually for being the first sketch. Yeah. People asking about texture and stuff. Maybe we could focus it a little bit. That's strange. Yeah. Like that. Here you see the texture. Texture. How I have been painting it layer by layer by layer by layer. Fascinating process. Yeah. 8.5 hours. And I'm really tired. It's a beautiful feeling. I surprised myself a little bit. Probably gonna do a little bit touch up tomorrow, but like kind of make it, give it a little bit more, say, contrasts. But yeah, wasn't just supposed to be an impressionist painting anyway, so. Anyway, here I am, tired, really tired. Well, as it says on my mirror, love is great, God is not, and we just have to do our best with the life we have, because it's probably all we have. I lost a couple of kilos while I was painting. Okay, anyway, good morning and good night from Norway. Yeah. Bye bye. Okay, here you can see the sketching process. I start on a tone canvas and I just kind of put in, I look at the motif and I just put in small points, and then I just start building and molding and building and molding. But I guess you have seen that in the video. If you want me to be your mentor, or you want to me to teach you how to paint, you can do that by going to Patreon and sign up for $5 and up, and I will answer all your questions and engage with you personally. So yeah, we artists need income, and having some money generated every month that is predictable is quite okay. And Patreon is the right place to get that done. So I hope to see you on Patreon, and I hope to see you in the next video. And leave a comment, thumbs up, and enjoy and keep painting.